Question 11. A long straight wire of radius r carries a current I uniformly distributed over its cross section. The magnitude of the magnetic field is, we have been given four options. We have to examine this option. First of all, let us calculate the magnetic field at a point inside the wire, then outside the wire. From that we can conclude which of this statement is correct. We are going to use Ampere's circuital law for solving this. Ampere's circuital law, which states that the line integral B dot dl over a closed curve equal to mu naught times the total current threading. So you want to find at the point P, the distance of the point P from the axis of the wire is r. Imagine the closed curve in the form of a circle. Then this becomes integral B dot dl becomes B into 2 pi r. That is equal to mu naught time the total current threading. The total current is spread over this cross section. So I by pi r square multiplied by pi r square. This is the total current that is going through this cross section. So cancelling this, what you get? We can cancel one r. So we see B equal to mu naught I by 2 pi r square times, which is constant r. So for inner points, B is directly proportional to r. For points which lie within the conductor. So from this you see r equal to 0, axis of the conductor r equal to 0. So it is 0 at the axis, and r equal to capital R, surface maximum at the surface of the wire. So two correct choices we have obtained by considering points inside the wire. Now let us consider points outside the wire. Okay, so we take a point P outside the wire. So let the point P be here. This is R. Now you should assume a circle of radius R. So this becomes B into 2 pi R equal to mu naught into I. So B equal to mu naught I by 2 pi R for external points, or B proportional to 1 by R. So for external points, B proportional to 1 by R, or B varies inversely as the distance from the axis for external point. So what are the correct options here? A, B, D. Three correct options.